So I don't know how I ended up on this bloody rod.
Start winding me.
Winding us up.
Look out.
Yep, there we go. We got him.
That one there took about, what, 30 seconds after dropping another bait.
That's all the drag we got.
Ooh, it's a big fish.
Ooh.
He's digging in.
That is smoking line, bro.
Stop.
Oh, that's a big fish.
Okay, this could get dangerous here, guys.
Welcome to, well, it's live for us at ultimatefishing.tv, hooked up to another nice swordfish. But the episode you're about to watch, feature episode, probably one of the greatest days swordfishing out. It was a father and son day. I've had my son fishing from humble beginnings.
Oh, there he is right there.
Yeah, boy, wine.
Great thing to do together, but on this day we caught a swordfish each, and one of them was pretty special. And there were some funny moments as my boy Shaw was wanting to be a man, a swordfish man.
See, it's all fun and games to you, mate, until I've had enough, Julian's had enough, and it's your turn on the rod.
No, I'm not going back
again. 10 hours in. And old Maddie Watson has to jump on the rod.
Never mind, Maddie, you can just call me Dad, thanks. Enjoy this full feature-length episode at ultimatefishing.tv, and please subscribe to our YouTube channel and check out all our social. Enjoy. We've got to get back to this.
So, weather?
Yep. Today we've got some good weather, so we've loaded some gear into the Staby craft. We've popped just out off the coast, and what we're going to try and catch is what is regarded all around the world as the ultimate fish to catch. It is a fish that is like no other in terms of the size that it gets, the power of it, and just its overall awesomeness. And the reason that it's like no other fish, it actually has no relatives. It has evolved all on its own, separate to all other fishes. And of course, I'm talking about the broadbill swordfish, the ultimate fish. And it is just crazy that what was once regarded as an almost mythical creature that has now become just a regular part of the New Zealand fishing season. You can go out and catch a swordfish, like we're going to do today, just like you will a marlin, a harpooker, a snapper, or a kingfish. So today we're going to show you how to catch a swordfish, and just while I'm rigging up this bait, we're going to take a look at why the swordfish has got this mythical, awesome awe about it. For me, this obsession with swordfish started 20 years ago when I was working on the prime time. And back then, all of the swordfishing we did was at night, because during the day, the swordfish are down over 500 meters deep. And it really felt like frontier fishing back in those days. We were out in the dark at these far off seamounts in the night trying to catch this mythical creature. And if we actually managed to catch one, it was almost like you'd conquered the Mount Everest of fishing.
Yeah, that's what we come here for, boys.
But these days, now that this day dropping technique has been developed, we're only going about half the distance offshore that we used to. It's during the day, and once you find a GPS mark, I mean, you don't need the same level of skill to just pop out in your tinny and catch a swordfish anymore. And so now with day fishing, it just got too easy. I mean, it got to the point where I'd watch my daughter play netball and my son play rugby on a Saturday morning, and then after sport, I'd pop out in my little boat and catch a couple of swordfish.
Yes, tag them, uh-oh.
So it got to the point where the mighty, mythical swordfish lost some of its aura. So what I did is I upped the stakes to make it exciting again and decided I'd go out and catch one on a handline.
I've got a swordie on my handline.
Oh, yeah.
And that's what I wanted to happen.
Well, actually, this guy up here was with me in my little Staby. It was actually your first billfish, wasn't it?
It was.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Julian hadn't even caught like a marlin. And so no time at all, we got Julian hooked up on the rod. And so I had to get rid of my handline. So I tied a float to it and threw it overboard while we fought Julian's fish. And 10 minutes later, we tagged Julian's first sword. It wasn't a very big one, but as it was swimming away, I looked up and I saw the float on my hand line just smoking off out to sea.
We might have a sword on there.
And after battling this thing on a hand line, the line was actually smoking out through my gloves. It's the one that famously got attacked by a Marco shark. and we ended up with a scrap on our hands, and we had to literally pull the swordfish right from the jaws of the shark to get it on board so we had something to take home and eat.
Come on, quick rope.
To give you an idea of how big that Marco was, like, it had a hold of that swordfish, it was shaking it around. When we got it back, it was like 256 or something.
Yep.
Yeah, big. So there you go. 250 kilos shaking it around in its mouth. But I think the point there is that it was a bit of a shame, really, that I had to go to such lengths, like using a hand line, to bring back my swordfish buzz. But after that experience of swordfish on a hand line, I just forgot about, you know, trying to catch swordfish myself. And it, for me, it became all about getting other people hooked up. And that really revived my interest in swordfishing again, because for a lot of other people, they were just still the ultimate. And taking people out, getting them hooked up to what is regarded as the best fish in the world was a real thrill, not just for the angler, but for me.
Swordfish, yeah!
If I take my hands away, I'm in the drink.
Seeing other people going through the physical and mental battle that it often takes to overcome a swordfish just brought back my appreciation for swordfish, because it is a fish that millions of anglers around the world would give their right arm to catch. And here we are, popping out in a trailer boat and just hooking into them off the coast of New Zealand. They are powerful, they're explosive, they jump, they'll even come and attack the boat, and, well, they just pull like nothing else.
Giving you a good pull, mate.
You reckon?
Yeah.
I've got so much respect for this fish, mate. They're pulled hard, eh? Which brings us to today, where I'm gonna drop this big squid down 600 meters here, and I actually expect that it's gonna get eaten by a swordfish, which sounds ridiculous to say that, because once upon a time they were so hard to catch. But now, most baits get eaten, and while we're waiting for this bait to get down, why don't I tell everyone about your first swordfish encounter, Ayshaw? It was a weekend mission. In fact, that's right, it was my birthday. And it was my mate Ben's birthday too. We shared the same birthday. And we brought Shaw along, but not to catch a swordfish. So we thought it'd be an opportunity for him to catch us some bluenose for a feed, and if he could catch us a gemfish as well, which are excellent sword bait.
Keep winding, bud, keep winding.
Catch a bloody gemfish.
So Shaw's on and he's pulling up his first ever gemfish from 350 metres, but he's not using the electric part of the electric reel because he wanted to catch it legitimate and earn his first deep sea fish. And then I turn around and I see the line angle coming up, and straight away I know what's happened. A swordfish has come along and eaten Shaw's very first gemfish.
Hold it tight, Shaw, hold on tight.
Yeah.
That's a big sword too.
So by this stage I knew it was a real big one, like a real big one. The old electric reel isn't designed for work like this. It's, even for a man, it's bloody hard just to even hold on to that rod. So we make up a makeshift harness. You know, it's not ideal, but at least it's taking some of that load off of Shaw just so we can hold the rod.
Your big tree trunk's working, mate.
A couple of weeks ago, Shaw was like,
can I catch a sword? Can I catch a sword?
I'm like, boy, you're not ready. And come out and watch the men do it. And I'll let you maybe pull in a gemfish or a blue nose.
Yeah, and just do the before and after. Look how fresh he looks now.
I'm going to be dead by the end of this.
Oh, no.
So by this stage I knew it was a real big one, like a real big one. And Shaw was like, yeah, bring it on. And they all say that. I mean, to be fair, everyone says that at the beginning, bring it on, they're all keen, full of bravado, but you just don't know. And is it a bite?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, we're bit. We're bit. Look at us. Geez, that didn't take long. Yeah, we got one on, I think. Get the gimbal belt, ball bags. I wind in the first 500 meters, you wind in the last 50. And I say that because the swordfish is just swimming up to the surface right now.
Do you want to put it on, or will I put it on for you?
No, you're putting it on.
No, you're putting it on. I'm not winding it. Come on, mate. Your fish.
See, he knows. See, he knows. See, normally he'd jump at the chance to get a fish. Go on then. So yeah, anyway, look at this. One hand winding in the mightiest fish. And that's because I'm not actually pulling the fish in. That fish is down there, circle hook in the corner of the mouth, careening up towards the surface. And actually, see, as soon as I stop there, it just goes slack. And that's because he's swimming up to the surface right now. And occasionally during the day, if they don't come all the way to the surface, but they stop part of the way up and they start digging down, that's when you're in trouble. Well, anyway, I better warn my... We got one on live. We got one on live. Let's concentrate on that one. Got real slack now. It's only 50 metres away. I'm on the mono. I'm going to have to fight this bloody thing. Look at this. It's slack. This fish is going to come right up here. Look, it's up on the surface. Look at that line angle. It's right up there. You know, it's coming forward, George. It's coming forward. Oh, it's right up there. Hang on, I've seen the boat. Uh-oh. Yeah, look, it's up on the surface. Look at that line angle, it's right up there. You know, it's coming forward, George, it's coming forward. He came, he was charging the boat. He was charging the boat. We have them do that all the time. Sometimes you can be hooked up and they'll come and start smashing at the boat, but hang on, I've seen the boat. Uh-oh. So, while I'm doing this, let's get back to Shaw's yarns. Now, where was I? Oh, that's right. So Shaw, his first time out fishing in the deep, he hooks a gem fish, but then it gets eaten by a swordfish.
Hold it tight, Shaw, hold on tight.
Yeah.
But he still wants to fight it manually, and he's been going at it now for a couple of hours. And it's a good thing he has no idea what he's in for, trying to fight a huge fish like this on bottom fishing gear. But so long as he's keen to give it a go, of course I'm going to encourage him, and also keeping him going is the counter on the reel. So he gets pretty keen when we get the fish close.
And at one point we had it 15 metres from the boat. It is now 374.
So this is where the mental side comes in. After hours of work, fighting for every inch of line, all of a sudden you have hundreds of metres of line disappear, and that's pretty hard to get your head around. It's now over 1,000 metres deep, but we've only got 600 metres of line and we could get spooled. So we're forced to apply more drag, which not only makes it harder on shore, it's now pushing this gear to the limit, and to make matters worse, it's starting to get rough.
Okay, so
we're just out off the coast here, probably only about 20 miles out. Hooked up to a broadbill swordfish, and while we're following this action here live, we're following Shaw's epic catches. We have plenty of time to come back to this. I'm going to see if I can do my best multitasking and fight this one and tell you these other stories.
Well, we're approaching the 4 hour stage and the wind's coming up. How are you feeling, bud? Average. Yep. It's a battle of wills as much as it is of strength.
And it just keeps getting rougher and rougher. This fish is still trucking out to sea. And as much as I wanted Shaw to get this fish, well, for all of us to get it, it's now more about testing Shaw's character, or rather, giving it a chance to grow, you know? Character building stuff.
How do you like it?
No one's allowed to do that laugh. That's my laugh. Oh, this could be a while, so let's go back to the yarn. After fighting this fish for over 5 hours, the fish just put on a big burst and boom, broke the line. Yeah, we were gutted. Shaw was in a crumpled heap on the beanbag, but to be fair, it wouldn't have been right if he'd got it while we weren't even trying. And he'll learn more from losing this fish than if he had have got it. And it was only a year later that he got another chance, this time out off the west coast. And the fishing had actually been really slow. And then at about 4 o'clock, whammo.
We got one on. Okay, ball bag, she's all yours, bud.
So Shaw now has a bit more of an idea of what he's in for, and we've got it hooked on game fishing tackle, which is good. And this time, I think Shaw might actually be ready.
Well, here we are again, bud.
On a Sunday
I knew Shaw's fish was a good one. I was genuinely hoping that it was sort of around that 200 kilo, maybe 250, which is a, like, I mean, that's a massive swordfish. I was just hoping that it wasn't like the 300 kilo plus one, like the first one that he'd hooked on the pooka rod. And that's what was getting to me. I hadn't seen it, just like this fish. This fish, it could be an epic. Sorry, back to Shaw's fight. Just like Shaw's, I hadn't seen it at that stage and I didn't know how big it was gonna be because it hadn't jumped. We hadn't seen the fish, but Shaw was pacing himself pretty well and getting himself set in case it was another big fight. And it was about an hour and a half in, it just came up and jumped.
Oh, oh, that's a good one.
Holy, that's a holy crap.
You saw it jump, eh?
Yeah.
And I think that's when you realised for the first time, you're like, oh, yeah. Oh.
I can see it. I can see it. This is real close, eh?
Yeah, it is.
Okay, so
it's right here, mate. We might get lucky.
It's a big bugger, eh? It's never mind. Just never mind. Okay, you might have to work into the corner, Shaw. Into the corner.
Yeah.
But give it a little bit, Benny. Give it a little bit, please. Yeah. Slow down now. Slow down now. Slow down now. Okay. Can you see the fish?
Yeah, I can see a whole.
That's a big one. Yeah. I'm gonna have to give it some drag. Inch him up, buddy. He's real close. I'm gonna better get that. Go a little bit, Benny. A little bit, please. Here's the double knot. A little bit more, Benny. Just a little bit more. Just a little bit more, Benny. Okay, you're gonna have to think about all the things I told you you had to do. He's right there. Jeez, he's a big one. I can't believe we've got him up this quick. Well, don't want to speak too soon. That's the double knot. You've got it on the reel. The swivel's open. The swivel's open. You've got to get it to me. The swivel is open. Mate, we've got to close it somehow. Okay, don't let the slack go off. I'm going to try and close it. Okay, it's closed at least.
It's a good one, eh?
You're going to see this thing right here in a second. Neutral, neutral.
Holy!
There it is, buddy. That's a big long sword. We got him.
The best moment for me was when Shaw got that first look at it and laid eyes on it. It was classic.
Whoa! Holy!
There it is, buddy.
That's a big long sword.
We got him.
Holy!
Woohoo! And then the thing just went absolutely crazy.
Look, look out! Let go of the end. Look, look out! Let go of the end.
Be honest, I do love that shit. You're gonna have to lead at this one. Has anyone thought about that?
I'll jump on the helm. Jordan, wanna grab a hold of the fish, mate?
And we've got colour. There it is. It's a swordy.
Okay, it's gonna jump just out here, boys. It's on to it here, it's gonna jump now. It's gonna jump.
There it is, right there.
Woo-hoo-wee. Right in the sun. As much as we tried to avoid that, there it goes, into the bloody sun. Oh look, here's the leader. Have you got your gloves on, Julian?
Yep.
Oh look at him, he's all covered up, look at that. Ah, he's right there. He's gonna go batshit. Sean, you're gonna have to go to the helm.
Julian, wanna grab a hold of the fish, mate?
Okay, idle forward please, Sean, just idle. Okay, just straighten the engines a bit.
Yep.
Listen to my instructions. Yep, you got him, mate. Backing the drag off. This is some serious multitasking shit going on here. This fish is not fought, mate. It's gonna be green as hell. Oh, look at the colours on it, mate.
Yeah, that looks cool, man.
That is beautiful. Yeah. Tell me if you're gonna dump.
No, we got him.
Oh, watch out, watch out, watch out. Okay. Let me know if you're dumping. You just give me a bit of warning if you dump.
Angry. Lining us up.
And the swordfish is the one fish, we've filmed it, documented it many times, that will go out of their way to have a go at you. They've had a go at me when I've been in the water with them, and alongside like this. You're trying to do the right thing, get a tag in them, let them go, and they will have a crack at you.
Got them.
Tags in them.
Well done.
Right in the sweet spot.
Woo-hoo!
Be careful, bro. Oh, he's trying to...
Oh, you bar.
Just careful, mate. Careful. Just let him go a bit longer. Let him go a bit longer. Let him go a bit longer. Nice quick one.
That was quick ass.
Yeah, I know.
It's pointing a good angler, mate. Don't muck around. Let's get the bill under the boat. Oh, your game, mate. Your game. Your game. Okay, hooks out. Do you want to
go? All good, all good.
Yeah, hooks out.
Great.
This fish, of course, is going back, and unfortunately, you can't release them all. But I've managed to release about 95% of them and they've swum away. Sometimes we have to vent them. This one's going to be healthy. But one day, you're going to get one that can't swim away. And they're the ones that you keep because they are amazing to eat.
Cool fish.
Look at the colours, eh?
They're awesome fish, aren't they?
They just
so
are.
So cool.
I think if you asked a kid to draw a picture of a swordfish, you know, that's just how they draw it. The big eye, the big upright fin, big tail, big long sword. They're just so animated. Oh, and the bulk. Even though this is a little guy, look at the bulk in him.
Okay, buddy. Thanks for the thrill and being another part of our story. The swordfish story continues. We're so lucky in New Zealand to have fish like that. Look at him. Away he goes back home from whence he came.
Nice. You know, like I did feel a little bit silly coming out here going, hey, you know, we expect to catch a swordfish mid-July. You know, it just extends our game fishing season. There's only been 2 months ever that I haven't caught a swordfish, which is October and November. But I've never tried in October and November. Big game fishing off the coast of New Zealand, year round. That there is an incredible resource that we've got. Incredible. Right.
Hey,
hey, write the script. Write the script, come out here, tell a few yarns, and that's me out. I'm off the rod now, boys. Woo! You boys, go. Let's go get another one. Hey, nice little league. Oh, you're going to get the next one, boy.
Yeah. And let it go, please, Shaw.
His angler's name, just write Dad.
Yeah, she won't be.
And we have recaptured swords. Amazingly, in the same area where we've let them go as well. So it just allows us to know how fast they grow and what their migration is, because these things do huge distances. Like these things travel to the tropics and back. And we're just so lucky that we have them here on the coast of New Zealand. I mean, what an amazing resource. Amazing. Honestly, it's like dropping down a ledger again. No, yep, got another sortie on.
Yeah, there we go. Yep, there we go. We got them.
Oh. Yeah, we got another one on, mate. That one there took about what? 30 seconds after dropping another bait. And it's not me on the rod. Yoo-hoo! It's like a lottery, mate. You could get the 80 kilo one or you could get the 400 kilo one. It's like swordfish roulette. Out there doing it with Dad. Might be, I hope there's a big one. That's on there. It's just a real big one, doesn't want to come up. That's a big boy.
Swordfish roulette.
Oh, I hope it's a biggie.
Very slowly.
Yeah, that's the what you're last thing you want. It's just a big one that doesn't care. He's like,
why couldn't I?
I love seeing that line ping.
Ping, ping, ping.
Fucking hold on. Oh,
that's a big boy drag on there, too.
Not soft baiting for your little snappers now.
We're running forward after this fish now and it's still dumping line.
It's not a little one, I don't think. Yeah, just come around a little bit more. We'll run an aggressive line, eh, Jules?
Hooked up at 150.
No use even keeping time now, mate. The old dad got his in 10 minutes, mate.
Mate, this is just like me getting you ready for school in the morning. Come on, mate, put your shoes on. Let Dad help you.
Yeah, there you go. How's that better?
Yeah, that's way better.
Now, basically, that's all that load. The load is actually going down on the thighs, and then, of course, your legs are connected to the deck, so all that pressure is essentially pushing down on you. So if you're running 25 kilograms of drag, well, that's 25 kilograms of force pushing down through the soles of your feet, if you can imagine. So the way I try to describe it to people is fighting a swordfish. If you were to get
say a 20 kilogram weight and put it on the end of a broomstick and just hold on to it and feel how heavy that is. Yes, the harness is going to take some of that load for you, but if you were to stand there holding a broomstick with 20 kilos on the end of it for 10 hours, I don't think anyone could do it. But when there's a swordfish on the end, just that adrenaline, just knowing, wanting to see more than anything what that is down there, it gives people superhuman strength. And I'm not exaggerating. You can do things when you're fighting a swordfish that you could never otherwise do, because it's within us, you know? And it's fight or flight, and if you're scrapping a sword, you soon know whether you've got the fight or not. That got a bit serious, Ian. Yeah. That got a bit serious, eh? That got a bit serious.
Look at this, just slowly taking mine, like super slow.
Because it doesn't even barely know it's hooked, eh? It's just...
Don't say that. You actually want to crush me.
I mean, well, we've seen it before, if you haven't seen it already on our footage. After 16 hours, fish coming back to the boat just to smash the boat up a bit and then swimming off again. Just because you've annoyed them. Mate, what sort of fish is that? It's crazy. They're insane fish.
Insane.
For your Instagram, I'll give you a plug. What's your Instagram name?
Follow me, I'm Matt Sun.
Now, what is your Instagram handle? I'll give you a plug.
Sure underscore Watson.
There you go. Sure underscore Watson. He's trying to get to 200 followers. Oh yeah, we've got colour.
Really?
I haven't even got my gloves on, so I'm more interested in getting the shot than getting the fish at the moment.
Oh, mate.
You're alright, mate.
You know, there is. Nah, there she goes.
But that's the thing, you can see these fish, and then they'll swim off like this, and you won't see them again for another 7 or 8 hours.
Oh. Oh.
Oh, swordfish ruling.
See, it's all fun and games to you, mate, until I've had enough, Julian's had enough, and it's your turn on the rubber.
No, I'm not going back
10
again.
10 hours in. And old Matty Watson has to jump on the rod.
Never mind, Matty, you can just call me Dad, thanks.
It's all jokes and banter at the moment, but I know Shaw isn't for one heck of a fight. So we're gonna have to keep Shaw's spirits up and his body hydrated and ready for the work ahead. As well as conducting and controlling the fight, it's now my job to look after Shaw and get him mentally and physically ready for battle.
You're thirsty.
Yeah, mate, I've caught a sword today. How about you? Some good parenting right there.
Swordfish roulette.
No, you're going good, mate. That's good.
He's charging us now, I think.
Keep him coming while he's coming, mate. Yeah. I want to get a look at him. You might have to go reverse right hand down, eh? Go for it. I can see him there. Get ready, Shaw.
There's a double.
Lead doubles here. I'm going to have to grab the bloody leader. I want to go.
Yeah. Right there.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Yeah, I know. Yes. Get ready, you might jump in front of us.
Oh, head shakes. He's going down. Good.
Okay, so we'll see if we can stop him getting back down.
Go.
You ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
Okay.
That's all the drag we got.
Oh, sound.
I love it's nice, that. Eh? Nice when you're not on the rod.
Ooh. We're coming to you live from off the Northland coast. Three baits, three swords. And now we've got this fella.
Hey.
On the rod. Although this fish does seem to be a bit bigger. We've been fighting this one for an hour and a quarter now. Hannah, your sister's watching Shaw. Oh, dude, wave?
Yeah.
Sorry, pretty new to this whole live sort of thing. Here, Shaw, someone's saying, go Shaw, get the dog. Oh, Cam's on there. Hey, Cam. Hey, bro. Far out. All the boys are jumping on. This is the way to do it. Oh, someone's saying, g'day from USA, watching us fight a sword. But I don't think we're going to get this fish anytime soon, eh? Over and out for now. Stay tuned. We'll try and update you. Doing live updates on our Facebook page. So if you follow us on Facebook, ITM Fishing, and Matt Watson Fishing Guy.
You can get it, see all this as it happens.
You look good, mate, don't worry. Girls are gonna love it.
Look at that thing go. That's a big one, boys.
Legs aren't feeling great.
Well, I know he's probably big enough and tough enough to stay in the boat, but we're fishing heavy drags, getting towards dark, and well, his mum's just not going to be that pleased if I come home without him. So there you go, you're strapped into the boat now.
The pressure is now really coming on, and I know this is a big swordfish. Not just because of how hard it's pulling, but the bigger ones tend not to jump, and they make regular visits up to the surface or even straight at the boat.
Okay, tagpole's just going here, mate.
So we have to be ready just in case we get a shot and are able to hold it boatside. The reality is though, we're not pulling this fish to the boat. It's coming to us because it wants to check us out. Because with a fish this size hooked in the corner of the mouth, the strain we're applying here has minimal effect on it.
Give it some drag, boy. Fuck the charger, Peter.
He's taking.
But of course, this load has an effect on the angler. Aside from the physical strain, this is where the mental strain kicks in. Watching all of that hard-fought line disappear off the reel, and really, there isn't anything you can do to stop it.
Yep.
Well, I'm gonna get the lights out because you're not gonna have this up before dark.
I've seen enough to know that this fish still has plenty of fight left, and it could be a while till we get to see it. That's if we get to see it.
Here we go again on the night shift.
But what I don't know is how Shaw is gonna cope with this if it carries on for several more hours.
Fish is working, that's good.
Yep.
It's about now the adrenaline is starting to wear off that Shaw's body would have released to give him strength and focus. Once you start making the fight about getting line on the reel or line going off the reel, you're then fighting the line and you're losing sight of the fact you're fighting a fish. And therefore, you lose the adrenaline that your body needs. And once this adrenaline's gone, it can get physically and mentally exhausting.
It's good, mate. It's good. Steady gains. Could be a while yet, though. It could be a while. It's almost like the swordfish get another gear when it gets dark. There's a big one on there. Just how big, we don't know. Just got to be patient, and hopefully we'll get to see it, buddy. Might see that sun come back up again yet. Had that happen before too.
That is the worst thing you could say.
Oh, look at that load, boy.
As darkness descends, this swordfish seems to grow in strength. While the opposite happens with Shaw.
Oh, man.
All anglers go through these ups and downs during a fight, but the onset of night is always hard for the angler mentally. Your muscles are cramping, you're in pain, and you can't see the end in sight. You can only see that line stripping off the reel, and you know how much it's gonna hurt to win that line back. But I do know that the feeling goes away, and there's a second or even a third wind that's gonna come along soon.
First time I've seen mono in a while.
This mono line means the fish is only 50 meters away, and this gives Shaw some hope. But at the same time, it can be said, hope disappears when that line disappears again.
Taking line.
That's all right, that's all right.
This is where you've got to remember that losing line doesn't mean you're losing the fight. You've got to forget about how much line is on the reel and just stay in the fight and make the fish work.
That was good, that was good. There was just a little bit of sparring there, mate. Making sure that fish knows you're still on the fight, boy.
Before we know it, another hour has gone by. We've now gone almost 6 nautical miles during the fight, and the fish has finally changed its pattern.
Mate, the fish is boosting. Yeah. Keep this going, Joel. Keep this going. Yeah. Give it some in reverse.
Nice.
There's the double knot, mate. You're almost there. Keep this coming. Oh, it's a big fish. It's a big fish, hey? Still got heaps of quagga in him, too. Mate, boosting.
Yeah.
Keep this going, Joel. Keep this going. Get ready to lean out, mate. We're running a really risky line here at the moment.
Yeah.
Go right hand down. Give it heat. Lean out, short, lean out. Back to drag.
Yep.
Push out, push down.
Yeah. Okay. No, that's all right. That was a clear thing, okay? Idle forward, we might get him. We might still get him.
Okay. He's stopped running.
He's up high, he's up on top.
We've seen the fish and it's given Shaw another fresh shot of adrenaline, but it won't last. So we're trying to grab this fish now, even though it's not yet beaten. It's just come back to have another crack at us. And once again, it's charging the boat.
Go now, go now. He's a fighter. Well, you're making him work, eh?
Yeah.
About an hour there, you were playing patty cakes with him. Now you're fighting him. He's now palm breaks.
Shaw is now desperate to end the fight, and he's clamping his palm on the spool. But this extra pressure works both ways.
Oh, that hurt bad.
Yeah, I know, mate, but we're almost there.
It's taking.
So this fish is about 20 metres away now. We had a good look at it just a moment ago. But as I can hear there, the line's disappearing again. Only be 20 metres away, but look at the speed of this run. That is smoking line, bro.
That's full drag.
Bit of a to and fro ding-dong battle, and you know, when it gets dark, I have seen grown men cry fighting these things, you know, after so many hours, and they're physically exhausted, they're cramped, muscles are sore, that's one thing, but it's the mental fatigue. You know, guys, some guys will fish their whole lives just to catch one of these things, and they want it so badly. I've just seen men's spirit get broken fighting these. But you'll be alright, bud?
Yeah.
Yeah, mate.
Of course.
As it starts to turn, just hold on, Sean.
Yeah.
Because you probably won't get your line, but it'll help our angle.
I'll hold him. He's digging in. Stop.
He doesn't have to turn much when he's close to change the angle.
Oh, he's up on top. I saw him. He's up on top.
Reverse around and get him. Let's go get him. I want to keep him on that angle, right where he is there now, to us. Right hand, get around.
Ah, that hurts.
Yeah, I know, mate, but we're almost there. Okay, here's our double, here's our leader. Got the leader.
Okay, Mark, back to drag off.
Oh, he's a big fish, boys.
Ooh. There you go, if you need.
Oh, jeez, he gave me a good pull. Fish ain't done yet, eh?
He's smoking.
You ready to have another pull back up?
Yeah, bro. Of course I am.
Oh, it stopped.
Yeah.
Good. Oh, yes.
Yeah, boy. Didn't even get off the mono.
You get him, boy. You get him, my son.
Hey, mug.
Reverse right hand down slowly. Are you in reverse?
Yeah.
Just reverse straight back here, we can stay alongside him. Oh, get ready, Sean.
Yeah, I'm ready. Back up.
Oh,
yeah, geez. Boy. Yeah.
Give me a proper pull, too. Right, that's good.
Yeah, it's a big one.
It's a fresh one, too, eh?
Yeah.
Just like I do for snapper, kingfish, anything these days, got a circle hook. Circle hook allows us to make a decision. So we use a J hook. A lot of the time they just get hooked in the throat and they bleed out. I mean, there are people that come out here to catch these and choke them with J hooks so they can't fight. And then they say they've caught a swordfish. Well, what's the point? You haven't really caught it. You've killed it from the moment it ate the bait. This way you get the true fight and you get to decide whether you want to release it or keep
it. Okay, my drag's loosened.
Okay, get the swivel to the rod to as soon as you can.
Okay, yeah.
Okay, I'm double wrapped on him. Just slow, mate. Just neutral, please.
Nearly go.
Reverse straight back. Reverse. Turn the motors the other way. The other motors the other way.
Left hand, go.
Okay, slow down, slow down, slow down, slow down. Neutral, please, neutral.
Reverse.
When he does that, mate, shit, he's a biggie, eh? Slow down, because it's going to load up on me in a sec. There he is.
Holy
shit, look at the size of it. Go reverse. Shit, he's bigger than I thought, eh? Right, you're like bigger than your last one, mate. Get your tag pop. Tag him. Yeah, tags in.
That's
him.
A big fish.
Look at this. It's a monster one, eh?
That is huge.
Oh, mate, that's 300. That's 300 kilo. That's 300 kilo, bro. That's 300 kilo. Look at him, look at him. Oh, mate, he's easy. That's. Look at the side of it, actually. That's. That could even be this well big. Vital forward, get on the helm, please. Okay, this could get dangerous, hey, guys. Look at how little that tag looks in it. That's. Look at that. I mean, it's just ridiculous. It's a barrel, bro.
It's real big. Look at the guts on it.
It's a big fish, boy. You did real well. Oh, mate, I just want to get some real accurate measurements on it. When the tail is level with the back of the boat, I want to get accurate
measurements. Yeah, like now.
Okay, so short length is here. I'll try and get in. Oh, shit. Roll the
yeah, grab the pole.
Roll the camera. Go on, mate. He's good. And he's released, buddy.
Well done, buddy. That was real good, eh?
Thanks, Ron.
That was big, I told you. Set to be patient.
Thank
well
you.
Done,
dude.
Awesome. Mate, that was as good as I've seen, man. Like, for a fish that size, it was teamwork. Buddy, that was over 300.
There you go. See it swim off too, eh?
I know, just swam all so good.
It powered off.
Hook out, just like that.
Yeah.
And there you have it, after all that time. We got it. And just add that one to the list of epic swordfish stories. Another one. You can check out more at ultimatefishing.tv. Thanks for tuning in, we're out.
I can't believe that, eh?
We hope you enjoyed this classic episode, but if you want to see the latest and greatest stuff from all around the world, you can get it all for free at ultimatefishing.tv or by downloading the Ultimate Fishing app.